thing that I got while I was thrifting this weekend. It was really fun. Speaking of thrifting, not really thrifting, but my friend invited me to half price books, and I was like, sure, why not? I don't really need to spend any money on books, but let's go. And she was looking for Locky Loxy, the sky is falling. The sky is falling. We must tell the president. Yelled Chicken Licken, Ducky Lucky, Goosey Lucy, and Cocky Locky. Well, come with me, said Foxy Locky. I know a shortcut to the airport. Foxy Locky led Chicken Licken, Ducky Lucky, Goosey Lucy, and Cocky Locky to the cave. To his cave. He didn't get... Oh. He didn't get to eat them, though, because Chicken Licken was almost right. The sky wasn't falling. So stupid. The table of contents was falling. It fell and squashed everybody. The end. Didn't chase the Stinky Cheese Man either, because he has two or three stomachs. Oh, how cute. The Stinky Cheese Man ran and ran until he met some kids playing outside school. Gross, said a little girl. What's that nasty smell? I've run away from a teacher will probably make us eat him. Let's get out of here. So the kids didn't chase the stinky cheese man either. There's the little girl and the little boy in the little corner. And the cow and the stinky cheese man. Just then, the sly fox, who shows up in a lot of stories like these, poked his head out of the bushes. "Why, just hop on my back and I'll carry you across, stinky cheese man. How do I know you won't eat me?" "Trust me," said the fox. So the stinky cheese man hopped on the fox's back. The fox swam to the middle of the river and said, "Oh man, what is that funky smell?" The fox coughed, gagged, and sneezed, and the stinky cheese man flew off his back and into the river, where he fell apart. The end. No princess would be good enough for their boy unless he could feel a pee one through 100 mattresses. So it should come to as no surprise that the prince had a very hard time finding a princess. Every time he met a nice girl, his mom and dad would pile 100 mattresses on top of a pee and invite her to sleep over. When the princess came down for breakfast, the queen would ask, "How did you sleep, dear?" The princess would politely say, "Fine, thank you." And the king would show her to the door. Now, this went on for 3 years. And of course, nobody ever felt the pee under 100 mattresses. Then one day, the prince met the girl of his dreams. He decided he better do something about it. That night, before the princess went to bed, the prince slipped his bowling ball under the 100 mattresses. When the princess came down for breakfast the next morning, the queen asked, "How did you sleep, dear?" "This might sound odd," said the princess, "but I think you need another mattress. I felt like I was sleeping on a lump as big as a bowling ball." The king and queen was quite satisfied. The prince and princess were married, and everyone lived happily ever after. Though, maybe not completely honestly, ever after all. The end. Ow! Isn't that so great? And that's how they kind of all go. There's quite a few more on, if you're interested. But I hope you have a good weekend. A good weekend. A good weekend. And I'll see you later.